service, the fifth Sunday after Trinity. The readings have been taken from the lectionary. Let's start with the hymn number MHB 590.
I invite our praise team and we start with our praise and worship.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's always a joy to be in the presence of God. Amen.
Amen.
Please, as many as can stand, can we all stand as we praise God?
Amen. Amen.
We praise thy name, O Lord. We praise thy name, O Lord. We praise thy name, O Lord. We praise thy name, O Lord, we praise thy name.
We praise thy name, O Lord.
We praise
thy name, O
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
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 a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh,
oh, Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. My brothers and sisters in Christ, we are celebrating a Mass for the fifth Sunday after Trinity. Intentions at this Mass is to thank God for our lives and for the gift of today. As we celebrate the Mass this morning, the Church is asking us whether we know our Master, whether we know our Lord, whether we know our Savior. If we know Him, then in this Mass, He is telling us that we should come to Him with our burdens. We should come to Him. He is humble, meek, and kind. And He is asking us to take His yoke, for His yoke is easy and His burden is light. As we celebrate the Mass this morning, let us pray for the sick in the parish, praying that God will pour His healing power upon them from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. And let us pray for our nation Ghana. We pray that the Lord should pour His blessings upon our nation Ghana. Bless us physically and spiritually, and bless us with the gift of peace, unity, and love. As we go through our celebration this morning, we remember and pray for Flair. They are thanking God for 55 years in service to God and mankind. And we are praying that the Lord should continue to pour His blessings upon this organization and help them to grow from strength to strength. We are praying also for our father, brother, and friend, Sam Okujatu, thanking God for 60 years today when he was called to the English bar. We thank God for all that He has done for him within these 60 years, grace and protection He has given him, and for service to God and to mankind. We are also praying for Auntie Erica, who is celebrating her 70th birthday today. We are praying that the Lord should open the gates of heaven and pour His blessings upon her and help her to grow from strength to strength. And we are praying for the souls of Kojo Yebu Abuafu and Gertrude Ella Doku. We are praying that the Lord will have mercy upon their souls, wash them in the blood of His Son Jesus Christ, and grant them eternal and everlasting rest. And I'll ask all of you to add your own intentions to the intentions that I've mentioned, so that together we offer them to the Lord. I'll please ask that we all stand. Let us together pray the prayer of purity. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom those secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters in Christ, by our baptism, we are priestly people. We are holy people. We are the royal priesthood, people who have been called out of darkness into the marvelous light of the Lord. But before we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving on the altar of God, let us call to mind sins against God and sins against our brothers and sisters. Let us please sit and make our humble confession as you say after me. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned in thought, in word and deed, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. I ask God Almighty to forgive me all my sins. May Almighty God have mercy upon all of us, forgive us all our sins, and bring all of us to newness of life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please stand. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. To God be the glory. The Lord be with you. Let us pray for forgiveness through the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Father, through the obedience of Jesus, your servant and your Son, you raise the fallen world, free us from sin, and bring us the joy that lasts forever. We pray for your servants and your handmaids who are celebrating their anniversary, who are celebrating their birthday, and who are commemorating occasion in their vocation and ministry. We pray for Flair on the occasion of their 55th anniversary. We pray for our father, brother, and friend, Samuel Kujato, for 60 years when he was called to the English bar. And for Auntie Erica on the occasion of her 70th birthday. Pour the riches of your grace upon them. Help them to experience your love. And above all, clothe them with the garment of righteousness so that they will grow from strength to strength. And we also pray for the souls of Kojo Yebu Abuafu and Gertrude Ella Doku. We pray that you grant them a place of refreshment, the blessedness of rest, and the brightness of your light. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please sit.
Zachariah chapter 9, reading from verse 9 through to 12. Zachariah chapter 9, reading from verse 9 through to 12. Rejoice greatly, daughter Zion. Shout, daughter Jerusalem. See, your king comes to you righteous and victorious, lonely and riding on a donkey, on a colt, a foal of a donkey. I will take away the chariots from Ephraim and the war horses from Jerusalem, and the battle bow will be broken. He will proclaim peace to the nations. His rule will extend from sea to sea and from the river to the end of the earth. As for you, because of the blood of my covenant with you, I will free your prisoners from the waterless pit. Return to your fortress, you prisoners of hope. Even now, I announce that I will restore twice as much to you. This is the word.
We shall chant Psalm 145 from verse 5 through to verse 15. Psalm 145, 8 through to 15.
Hear the word of God as it is written in Romans chapter 7, verse 15 to 25a. Romans 7, 15 to 25a. I do not understand what I do, for what I want to do, I do not do, but what I hate, I do. And if I do what I do not want to do, I agree that the law is good. As it is no longer I myself who do it, but it is sin living in me. For I know that good itself does not dwell in me, that is, in my sinful nature. for I have the desire to do what is good, but I cannot carry it out. For I do not do the good I want to do, but the evil I do not want to do, this I keep on doing. Now, if I do what I do not want to do, it is no longer I who do it, but it is sin living in me that does it. So I find this law at work. Although I want to do good, evil is right there with me. For in my inner being, I delight in God's law. But I see another law at work in me, waging war against the law of my mind and making me a prisoner of the law of sin at work within me. What a wretched man I am. Who will rescue me from this body that is subject to death? Thanks be to God, who delivers me through Jesus Christ, our God. The word of God.
Our gradual hymn is Methodist Hymn 154, 154.
Lord be with you.
Hear
the continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, reading at the 11th chapter, from the 16th through to the 19th, then from the 25th through to the 30th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
The Gospel according to Matthew chapter 11, reading from verse 16 to 19, then from verse 25 through to 30. To what can I compare this generation? They are like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling out to others. We played the pipe for you, and you did not dance. We sang a dirge, and you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say he has a demon.
The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say he's a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. But wisdom is proved right by her deeds. 25-30. At that time, Jesus said, I praise my Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and learned and revealed them to little children. Yes, Father, for it is what you were pleased to do. All things have been committed to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I'm gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Beloved, the gospel of Christ.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Our hymn before the sermon is Methodist hymn 608.
Let us pray. Gracious and ever-living Father, we are very grateful to you. We thank you for calling us out of darkness into your marvelous light. And we thank you for making us a priestly people, a holy nation, people who have been called out of darkness into your marvelous light to give you glory, praise, and adoration. And Lord, as part of this worship, it is now time to listen to your voice. And so, Lord, I pray that may let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our Redeemer. Amen. Good morning, my brothers and sisters. I welcome all of you to our celebration this morning. In our celebration this morning, the church is asking us, do we know the Messiah? The one called Messiah. Do we know him? Can we identify our Lord, our personal Savior, Jesus the Christ? Can we identify him? Do we know him? Do we have a relationship with him? Is there any fellowship between us and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ? Now, the church is asking this question because for about 4 weeks now, Jesus is calling us to be his disciples. That is the teachings we have been going through. And so the church is saying, you have heard him telling you that renounce yourself, take up your cross and follow him. You have heard him that you must not love your mother, brother, or sister more than him. And so as you have heard him, do you know him? Have you established a relationship with him? Is he your Lord, your master? Is he your savior? That is the question the church is asking. And that is a growth that the church expects from us in this period. We must grow spiritually. Growing spiritually means we must know the Messiah. We must establish a relationship with the Messiah. There must be a fellowship between us and our Savior, our Master and friend. And so the first reading tells us that the Messiah, the Savior, is not carrying the flesh, so we can't see him. But we'll know him. We'll know him by his deeds. We'll know him by his word, character. And so the first reading tells us that the Messiah is one who is bringing peace. The Messiah is somebody who is humble. He is meek. He is gentle. And therefore, if you are looking for him, that is the person. He is gentle. He is meek. He is humble, he is merciful, he is loving, he is compassionate, and he is prepared to bless you with a gift of what? Peace. And that is why the prophet says he is not coming on a horse, but he's coming on what? A donkey, bringing you peace. And so the church is answering the question, who is the Messiah? The Messiah is the one who is carrying the message of what? Peace. The Messiah is the one, when you come into contact with him, you experience peace within. He is the one who is humble. And so when you have an encounter with him, you yourself will be a humble person. He is somebody who is merciful. He is compassionate. And therefore, when you experience him in your life and you are in communion with him, you will be a merciful person and you extend the spirit of compassion to other people. And that is what the first reading is telling us. And that extends to the psalm we have just chanted. The psalmist is telling us that God is loving. God is merciful. God is kind. And all these that the psalmist is telling us is saying that the Son of God has incarnated in the flesh. So in him, we are going to experience kindness. In him, we are going to experience gentleness. In him, we are going to experience what? Humility. And that is why the church is calling upon all of us to make sure that we encounter the Messiah, we encounter the Savior, we encounter our Lord and Master, and establish a relationship with him. But the church is also telling us that much as we are going to make effort to discover the Messiah, to have an encounter with him, to have a fellowship with him, for him to be our Master and Lord, somebody will be fighting against us. And that person is sin. All effort we're making, getting closer to the Savior, the sin will also be what? Drawing us back. And so the experience of St. Paul come to bear in our second reading. That if you open up to sin, the good that you want to do, you'll not be able to do. It is the bad things that you are running away from. They are the very things you'll be able to do. And so if you are making effort to search for the Savior so that you'll be like the Savior, St. Paul is telling you that turn your back to what? Sin. Hate sin, but love the sinner. Hate sin, but love who? The sinner. St. Paul is telling you that every activity that will lead you into sin, alienate yourself from it. Because your focus is to meet what? The Savior. Your focus is to experience the Savior in your life. Your focus is to make sure that the Savior is your friend. He is your brother. He is your king. He is your shepherd. He is your master. And therefore, nothing should derail you from pursuing your vision of experiencing the Savior in your life. My dear people of God, the gospel message tells us that our Lord and Master Jesus Christ came. And his main vision is for everybody to know him. And so right from the word go, he opened his arms, making sure that everybody will know him as the Messiah. Everybody will know him as the Savior. Everybody will know him as the one God has sent to redeem us. But if you read the gospel carefully, if you start from Matthew chapter 11, John the Baptist, the forerunner of our Lord Jesus Christ, came and he was in the wilderness and he was calling upon the people to repent. And they said, you can't live among the people and you are in the wilderness. There's a demon in you. We won't accept you. And so John worked up to a point, and so he sent his disciples to Jesus to ask him, are you the one who is to come, or shall we look for another? And Jesus told the disciple, go and tell John what you see. The blind receive their sight. The deaf are now hearing. The lame are walking. And the word of God is being preached to the poor. In other words, Jesus is saying that I've also embarked upon my ministry. And I'm making the message known to the people of God. And now we come to today's message. He said, we have children that when you play the flute for them, they will not dance. We ask them to cry too, they won't what? Cry. Now, this is a figurative message that our Lord is using. John was in the wilderness calling upon them to repent. That is a cry. They did not respond. He came and told them, I'm the Savior. I'm offering you life. That is joy. They did not repent. And they called him what? Somebody who is glutton and a drunkard. Now, that is a phrase used for somebody who is against the tradition of the people. So it means they rejected Jesus. My dear people of God, and that is why Jesus prayed and said, Lord, I thank you that you have revealed this not to the learned, but what? To the children. The learned were the Pharisees, the theologians of the time, the Sadducees, the aristocrats. They rejected the Messiah. They rejected the forerunner. And so Jesus came to the downtrodden, the poor, the rejected. And then he manifested himself to them, and they received it. And that is why Jesus was thanking God that all that was revealed to the learned and the people who think they know, they rejected it. But the children, they have what? Accepted it. And so if they have accepted it, Jesus prayed that they should come closer. They should come with their burden. They should come with their sorrow. They should come with their anguish. They should come with their problems and predicaments. And he's going to give them what? Rest. Because he sympathized and empathized with them. For him, they have carried the load for a very long time. And all that they need now is what? Rest. And so Jesus is telling you this morning that for a long time you have been crying. For a long time you are carrying load. But he's inviting you to come. When you come to him, you are going to experience rest in him. Our Lord said, take my yoke. For my yoke is easy and my burden is what? Light. Why is the yoke of the Lord easy? Because his yoke is full of what? Love. And where there is love, the yoke will be what? Easy. And the burden is what? Light. So if you draw to Jesus Christ, the yoke you are going to carry, it will be yoke of love. And it will be easy. And the burden will be light. I pray that we all come to Jesus. I pray that we all take the yoke of Jesus upon us. For his yoke is easy and his burden is light. And I want all of us to experience this yoke so that we'll give glory to our Father in heaven. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please stand. Let us all affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty.
the life everlasting. Amen.
We are on the altar of thanksgiving for just being counted among the living. We thank you, God, for bringing us to the seventh month of the year. Seven is a release of supernatural unction to function in order to tap into the supernatural blessings. Let us pray. Prayer for the sick, elderly, and needy. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, you came to the earth that we might have life and have it abundantly. Throughout your time on earth, you healed the sick and brought comfort to the suffering. We are calling on you for our healing. On this day, we ask that you be with those of us who are sick, and if it is your will, restore us to full health. Above all, bestow your peace, which passes all understanding. We are also thankful for your great love for the elderly in our midst. You have sustained them in health, in sickness, and every moment of their long lives. Heal us from all bodily illness, but more importantly, minister to our spiritual illness. Bless the efforts of all who minister in your name. May we be charitable and compassionate towards the less fortunate in our homes, family, and the communities, and wherever we may find ourselves. Lord, in your mercy. Prayer for opening of schools. We thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for the opportunity to receive formal education. Teach us that attending school involves a joint endeavor between parent, teacher, and student working together. Bless all our schools and all who participate in the educational process. Grant your special blessings to the schools which include your word as part of their school curriculum. Help us remember that it is wise to treasure knowledge of you, and that true wisdom of you through Jesus Christ brings eternal happiness. May your word penetrate our hearts, making us wise unto salvation. Lord, in your mercy. Prayer for the world and our nation. Let us commit our world into your hands of the Lord, and especially our motherland Ghana. It is said that a nation that honors God is blessed. We are therefore committing our leaders, all in authority and decision-making position or office, into your capable hands. We pray for the Holy Spirit to descend mightily on them, so that their decisions will be to honor you, Lord, and for we, the populace, to pray to yearn for the things of the Lord. Let us pray unceasingly, interceding for all and country. You have ordained that we should work and earn our daily bread by the labor of our hands. Bless, we pray, the economy of our country and all the economies of the world. Help those able to work to find a productive job and receive a fair wage in return. Begin with us, the people who bear your name, and the people who bear the name of your son. Ensure justice and honesty in all our dealings with each other, and inspire businesses and labor to work together for the common good of all. May all that we do reflect your glory through Jesus Christ, our Lord. May your mercy and blessing be upon the powers which you have ordained over us. Lord, in your mercy. Prayer for the church. Father, the church is your house of prayer for solace and to glorify you with praise, adoration, and thanksgiving for your sufficient grace, mercy, and favor. In your presence, we are one body, in one spirit with you. We are called to be open to the Spirit, leading us to build peace, to bear fruit, walk in the light of your word, be truthful in worship and work, and use us to build a spiritual house. Empower our priests with divine unction and wise counsel as they teach, and help us to grow our spirituality and faith. In your goodness, continue to pour out your blessings upon us and make us faithful members of your holy church. Lord, keep our priests as spotless as the host. Lord, in your mercy. Prayer for the family and children. We bring all families to your throne of mercy. You, Lord, know it all before we come to unburden it at your feet. Let us enter into serious warfare to pray out that which is destroying our sons and daughters, husbands and wives, and in the family. Each home has its own peculiar issue. Lord, make a way where there seems to be no way. You are God and have the power to overturn and overrule. Lord, in your mercy, we join our members who are acknowledging your goodness in their lives. A grandmother is thanking the Almighty God for seeing her granddaughter, Fiona, through secondary school and on her way to the university. She prays that the Lord continues to protect, direct, and guide her. Her text is Proverbs 3, verse 5 through to 6. On the occasion of the 55th anniversary of Flair Catering Services Limited, the board, management, staff, and students are thanking God for his mercy and many blessings over the past 55 years. They pray for God's guidance in the years ahead. Their hymn of praise is Methodist Hymn 578. Sam Okujato gives thanks to the Lord who has sustained him as he celebrates his call to the English bar on 9th July 1963, that is 60 years. Today, the 9th of July 23. His psalm of praise is Psalm 100, verse 1 through to 5. Auntie Erica is thanking God Auntie Erica is thanking God for blessing her with 70 years of life on the 4th of July. She affirms God's faithfulness in all the ups and downs during these years and humbly asks for good health to serve him in the next 30 years. Her hymn of praise is Presbyterian Hymn 485. The family of the late Kojo Yebo Abuafo thanks the Lord for his life on earth and for God granting them the grace and strength to give him a befitting burial on the 6th of July. Their hymn of praise is Methodist Hymn 427. The family of the late Mrs. Gertrude Eladoku thanks the Lord for her life and work whilst on earth and for the grace of granting her a befitting burial on Saturday, the 1st of July. Their text is Psalm 121. The psalm of praise for all the thanksgiving is Psalm 27, 1 to 5. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. Lord, in your mercy, please bring your individual prayers, petitions, desires to the great I am. Repeat and confirm what he knows already for a speedy answer. Please bring your prayers to a close. What then shall we render to him, the Christ, for all the wonderful blessings he has bestowed on us? As we leave his presence, may we go in his mighty grace, do one good turn, honor someone, encourage a weak one and lowly. Then you will fled the Christ in you. And bringing all our burdens, sorrow, sin, and care, at his feet we lay them and leave them there, to let go for him to take control. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please stand. According to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us all greet Allah with the sign of peace.
Our first offertory hymn is Ancient Methodist Hymn 99.
We'll continue with the Methodist hymn 515, 515.
Thank you.
We continue with Methodist hymn 516, 516.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, let us in this Mass pray for God's blessings upon Auntie Erica as she celebrates her 70th birthday. Let us pray that the Lord will clothe her with a garment of righteousness. The Lord will fill her heart with joy and happiness. And so also we pray for our father, brother, and friend Sam Okujatu as she celebrates 60 years of his call into the English bar. We pray and thank God for the wisdom bestowed upon him for the past 60 years in active practice. And we pray that the Lord will renew his strength. The Lord will grant him more grace to do everything to the honor and place of his glory. So as we pray for Flair, as they thank God for 55 years in service to God and mankind, we pray that the Lord will grant them a window of opportunity as they start their 55th year. And we pray that their business will continue to grow from strength to strength. O Lord, hear our prayer. Let us also pray for the repose of the soul of Kojo Yeboah Boafo and Gertrude Ella Doku, that the Lord will have mercy upon their souls, wash them in the blood of his Son Jesus Christ, and grant them a peaceful rest in his arms. O Lord, hear our prayer. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God our Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive the sacrifice at our hands, to the praise and glory of his name, those who are benefits and that of all solutions.
Amen. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, who with thy only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit art one God, one Lord, not one holy person, but three persons in one substance. For that which we believe of the glory of the Father, the same we believe of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, without any difference or inequality. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we loud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, please sit. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, pour your blessings upon this offering, so that for us it becomes the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this Eucharist. The night before he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ took bread, gave you thanks and praise, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Amen. When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. Gave the cup to his disciples and said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which is shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this as often as you shall drink it in remembrance of me. Amen. Oh, come, then. Brothers and sisters, let us proclaim the mystery of our faith.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memory of our redemption, O Father, in this oblation of bread and wine, recalling the death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Sanctify this bread and wine so that for us becomes the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the drink of new and ending joy in Him. Sanctify us individually also and help us to worship you in unity, constancy, and peace. And that at the general resurrection, the last day, we may be found acceptable in your sight. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us pray the prayer our Savior Christ has taught us. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. So we are many. We are one body. Because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God. Jesus, bearer of our sins. Jesus, Redeemer of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are those who are called to this supper.
Our first communion hymn is Methodist hymn 517, 517.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord, may we never fail to praise you for the fullness of life and salvation you give us in this Eucharist. We thank you for the gift of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, to be a medicine for our soul. And we pray that you dismiss us with your blessing. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Prayer after communion.
Almighty God, thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work for your grace and glory. Amen.
Place it.
Hello, hello, hello out there. It's time for our family month. And for this year, we want to invite you, I want to invite you to join us. There are loads and loads and loads of stuff for us to learn. Come, let's learn about our church, how far we have come, what made us come here, and how far we would want to go. Come, let's have fun as we sit at the feet of elders. Come, let's learn about the roles and rules regarding our liturgy. Let us learn about the family as a unit, the family as a church. My brother, my sister out there, the disciplines of a home relies on the father and mother. And in this year's Family Month, we're going to treat things like that. And oh, if you think none of them is okay with you, come join us for the cookout and the family fair. Believe you me, we'll crown it all up with our joint family service, the mega joint family service, where Ridge Main, Ridge Manet, and Ridge Woodu will come together. We'll be in the hall, beautifully clad in our kente and our traditional wear. You can't miss a single day, from the 1st through to the 31st of August. And oh, those married for the past 2 years and counting, come join in the marriage course. 7 Sundays, solid teachings. You can't miss a point. Sundays are clad with purposeful sermons and homilies. Focus on the family as a church and the family as individual homes. You can't miss out. I trust to see you, and I'll call you, I'll text you, I'm counting on you. See ya.
Good morning, family. I'm here to launch Family Month 2023. Accra Church reserves August each year to the observation of Family Month. It is a time for reflection and revival, celebration of the wonderful gift and the mystery and the institution that is marriage. During Family Month, we concentrate on the Christian home, which is the pillar to the flourishing of the body of Christ. This year, Family Month will be held under the theme, Living the Transformed Life, the Christian Home at the Crossroads. This theme will be explored throughout the month of August, and we'll use 4 main ways to address this theme. On Sundays, it will be addressed at every service, at Ridge, at Tudu, and at Manet. On Wednesdays from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Anaviosi sessions. On Saturdays, we will have events, quizzes, fora, and an exciting family cookout and family fair. Whose jollof will bring the house down? Whose banku and okra stew will silence the critics? Whose apim and abom will wow the crowd? Want to know more? Come for the family fair on the 26th of August at the Main Ridge. The There will be a playground for the little ones, prizes to be won, business exhibition booths, and so on. Be assured of a wonderful time. And then also, every Sunday, from the 16th of this month, July, to the end of August, we will have the marriage course. The marriage course will be held over a period of about 7 weeks from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Accra Ray Church and also at the Calvary Methodist Church. Registration costs 500 cedis for the marriage course per couple. Thanks to generous donors, however, there are some discounts and fee waivers for some couples who may be in need of them. Now comes the most exciting part, which I'm sure you're all waiting for. Ephesians 2, 19 to 21 says, So then you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the cornerstone, in whom the whole structure, being joined together, grows into a holy temple for the Lord. This passage calls for reflection on the concept of family, as one that encompasses all who share in the blood bond of salvation through faith in Jesus Christ. In accordance with this knowledge, as a highlight of this family month, we are introducing an exciting new initiative where members will blindly pick one of five families to be affiliated with: the loving family, the joyful family, the peaceful family, the patient family, or the kind family. This is to encourage bonding among members, as well as organize good-natured competition, adding an edge of excitement to the month's events. Keep an ear out for more announcements concerning how this will be done and how you'll be able to choose which family you belong to. I hereby encourage you to participate in the activities for this family month in August. We have given you more than almost a month's notice, so no excuse. And we pray that we'll be able to strengthen ourselves as a church. On this note, I pronounce Family Month 2023 duly launched. Thank you.
Today is Sunday, 9th July 2023, fifth Sunday after Trinity. Bands are published between Emmanuel Nemate Bate and Naakle Odonko. This is the first announcement. If anyone knows any just cause or impediment as to why this couple should not be joined in holy matrimony, he or she must contact the ministers. Other information. Prayer and Fasting Month, July 2023. The 31 days of prayer and fasting is under the theme, Cultivating the Fruit of the Spirit, Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. All ARC members are encouraged to take part to have an amazing time with the Lord throughout the month of July. The schedule for reflections. There's a virtual morning devotion every Monday to Saturday from 5 a.m. to 5:30 a.m. It is via Zoom. Afternoon reflection service is held here at the Ridge on Mondays and Wednesdays from 12 noon to 1 p.m. Evening reflection service is also held at Ridge Church here on Mondays and Wednesdays from 5:30 p.m. to 7 p.m. Half-night service is held here at the Ridge and also at Manet every Friday from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. at the Ridge, and from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. at Manet. The July Special General Meeting for the consideration of the Church's spiritual matters, church life and nurture, is scheduled for Sunday, 30th July, 2023. It will be preceded by a joint service at 8:30 a.m. here at the Ridge. There will also be a joint service at Manet starting at 8 a.m. The agenda has been posted on the notice boards. The 6 p.m. service has resumed and is ongoing. If for any reason you are unable to join any of our morning services, please join us here at the Ridge for the 6 p.m. service. You are invited to join our midweek morning meditation here at the Ridge this and every Wednesday from 6:30 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. Members are encouraged to drop their prayer requests into the prayer boxes provided at the main exit and entry points. If you are preparing for marriage, the Marriage Preparation Committee would like to meet the couple and their parents or representatives. This will be a Zoom meeting on Tuesday, 11th July, 2023, from 5:30 p.m. Please call the church office on 0302-222-879 and book a slot of 20 minutes. Remember, no preparation, no ceremony. Couples are also encouraged to give themselves up to 6 months planning for best preparations. Teen Camp 2023. Teen Camp is fast approaching, and we are excited for what God has prepared for our teens this year. We invite all teens between the ages of 13 and 18 years to join the ARC Teen Camp 2023. Starting today after service, registration desks will be set up outside the sanctuary for registration and payment of camp fees. Fee payments and donations can also be made by following the payment instructions on the poster. The link for registration may also be found on the poster, or you may simply scan the QR code also on the poster. The deadline for registration is 31st July, 2023. The ARC Family Month Planning Committee will run the marriage course together with Calvary Methodist Church at Abraka on Sundays only, starting from the 16th of July to 27th August, for 7 weeks, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. This is open to all couples married for over 2 years. The course will make your marriage even more enjoyable and not one to merely endure. The cost for the 7 weeks is 500 Ghana cedis per couple. It includes learning materials and snacks. Interested couples should please pay to the church office. For further details, please contact Reverend Kofi and Mrs. Doris Ankama Samwa on 0244-664464. The Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship International presents 2023 FGBMFI World Convention, dubbed Ladies Conference, under the theme Empowered for Service. The Accra Ridge Church is invited to the conference on Friday, 14th July at 2 p.m. at the Grand Arena of the Accra International Conference Center. In celebrating their 45th anniversary since qualifying as medical students, the class of 1978 of the University of Ghana Medical School will be worshiping with us next Sunday, 16th July, at the 10:30 a.m. service. Funeral announcements. Pre-burial and burial service for the late Engineer Robert A.O. Okai, a member of this church, will be held here on Saturday, 15th July at 8:30 a.m., followed by a private burial. Funeral reception takes place at the Fellowship Center. He was the husband of Mrs. Dora Nakokoi Okai, father of Mrs. Delia Okai Agbozu, Reginald Okai, and Robert Andy Okai, all members of this church. Pre-burial and burial service for the late Mr. Felix B. Longdon, a member of this church, will be held here on Friday, 14th July at 8:30 a.m., followed by a private burial. Pre-burial and burial service for the late Kofi Labi Sampong, a member of this church, will be held here on Thursday, 13th July at 8:30 a.m., followed by a private burial. The end of the announcements.
We invite all those celebrating their birthday for the church's blessing.
We shall sing Methodist hymn 413, the first stanza only.
Gracious and everlasting Father, we are very grateful to you for our mothers who are celebrating their birthday. We join them and David, your servants, in saying, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that within me bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not his benefits. Lord, for all these years, you have poured your blessings upon them. You have poured your grace upon them. You have granted them protection. And so on the occasion of their birthday, they are thanking you and giving you all the glory and adoration. We pray that you open the gates of heaven and pour your blessings upon them. Grant them the gift of wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And above all, fill their heart with joy and happiness. And help each one of them to rejoice in the power of the Holy Spirit, giving glory and honor at all times. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, be upon you. Be upon you. Those who are here praying for souls and thanking God for them, please stand. Let us pray. Gracious and everlasting Father, we thank you that your word says that we are formed out of dust, and into dust we shall return.
In the fullness of time, you have called these your servants and handmaids to rest, and we are here thanking you for their lives. We pray that as a family go through a period of grief and sorrow, you will console them, grant them joy, and above all, bring them together in this period of grief and sorrow, so that they will know that all those who carve their care on you will continue to experience your protection and guidance. And so, Father, bless each one of them according to their needs. And so fill them with joy and happiness so that they will continue to serve you as expected of them this moment and forevermore. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep each one of you this moment and forevermore. Amen. Please sit. We now invite Flair to come for the church's blessing. Members of the Flair organization.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Bless, grace, and honor we give to you, O Lord, for Flair Catering Services, 55 years of existence in the hospitality industry, providing food, beverages, savories, and all to feed man. Lord, we pray everything you have done. As they journey on from here, connect them to new messages, new business ideas, and pour upon them your life-giving spirit. You, who is the chef in life's kitchen, be the chef in this industry. Direct, preserve, and bound them with your cord of love. As they honor you in this day, honor them, O Lord, as individuals and collectively as an establishment. May your divine mercy and assistance lead their going out and coming in and cause them to continually walk in that greener pastures. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We will now invite our father, Mr. Sam Okujato, for the church's blessing on the occasion of 60th anniversary call to the English Bar.
Let us pray. Christ our mediator, Christ our advocate, Christ our savior. Thus far you have brought your servant in mediating and advocating for the lives of men and women on earth. 60 years ago, Lord, you called him to the English Bar, and you have fulfilled your work in him. We pray, O Lord, use him as an epitome to teach the values and principles of honesty, to stand, to advocate, and to mediate for men. Strengthen him again, O Lord, with the gift of wisdom, that as others look up to him, they will draw inspiration from him. Because Christ, you is the one who feeds him with inspiration. We ask, O Father, use him as a father in the sands of time to honor and bless your name. And as we all join to thank you for how far you have brought him, so we pray an extension of blessing upon the family and all those who have the care of him. Above all, clad him with your giftings from above to do this now and always. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Now, unto God's gracious mercy and protection, we commit you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord makes his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, be with you this moment and forevermore. Amen. Please, if we have members of the Full Business Men's Fellowship here, please stand for us to acknowledge your presence. Yeah, a round of applause for them. You are welcome. You are welcome, and God bless you. And by extension, all who are worshiping with us for the first time, we welcome you, and we pray God's blessings upon your life. Amen. Amen. Now, we want you to know that we are in the month of prayer and fasting. A month of prayer and fasting, and we are expecting all of you to participate in all the programs. Mondays, Wednesdays, we are here at 12 noon to 1, and then it's prayer. Now, early in the mornings, by Zoom, you get your morning devotion. But what we are pleading with you is, if you are working around, you know, don't watch the Zoom meetings. Please come here if you are around, you know, to enrich whatever we are doing. Now, if you are on retirement and you are relaxing, just take it to stretch your limbs and come here. You know, all the sessions. And those who were here around last week will tell you that they were seriously blessed. And so we are inviting all of you. And by this announcement, if you have not started a fast, please join the bus. We know a lot of people are taking it for granted. This is a family, the church. And together we are in a month of what? Prayer and fasting. So we are praying with all of you. Get involved, and the Lord will bless you. Amen. The Lord be with you. Now the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon all of you, upon all your work and worship done in his name. May he give you light to guide you, courage to support you, love to unite you this moment and forevermore. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Our recessional hymn is Methodism 589. 589.